Hi, I'm Alexa Meade. I'm a 24-year-old artist from Washington, D.C. What's interesting about my work is that it's a combination of performance, installation, photography, and painting. So there's a lot more things to take into account than if you're just taking a simple photo or a simple painting or just an installation. Today I'm going to be painting my friend Will. It's one of my favorite models. I've painted him several other times. I began painting on my first models in, I believe, April 2009. So it's been almost 2 years now. With the first person I painted, he really wasn't clear on this project. He thought that I wanted to paint a picture of him on canvas. And he didn't understand until I put the first brushstroke on his cheek that, no, I was painting on him, not painting a picture of him. There's a lot of preparation work that goes into each piece, probably between 10 and 40 hours for the background, the clothing, if there's other objects that are going to be in the scene. And then on the day of, all I do is paint the face and any other exposed skin. Typically, Champollet deals with making something two-dimensional look three-dimensional through painting it so expertly that you would swear that it was a real thing that existed in space. And what I'm actually doing is the opposite of that. I'm taking something that exists in real three-dimensional space, and I'm collapsing it into a 2D plane. It's a really rare opportunity that someone has to get to know someone that personally. It's almost like a collaboration, in a way, because so much of it is dependent upon this personality of this person sitting several inches away from my face. Whereas if I were just painting a picture of them on canvas, it would be a very different dynamic. I think it builds upon the history of portraiture, and it's pretty interesting too, because when you paint a picture of someone on canvas, you're capturing their likeness, but you're not capturing them. And yet in my project, I'm both painting a picture of someone and capturing them through the photography. So at once you're looking at a photo of someone, but also the artist's representation of them through painting. The physical painting only lasts for a couple of hours. It's a photo that endures. There's no way to have this enduring painting, and it must be mediated through photo or video in order for it to survive. And really, the final end product is such a result of every step of the way of painting, with, you know, the attitude of the model and my mood going into it and just us bouncing off of each other. And I think that every work I do builds off what comes before it. And when I'm working on a current piece, that will inform the way I work on the next piece. So I see it all as part of this context that allows me to keep on building upon it.